Hello, this is Mark from Excel Off the Grid. If this is your first time here and you want to take your Excel skills to the next level, then start right now by subscribing and getting notifications so that you don't miss a single video. I recently attended an online meetup where Danielle Stein Fairhurst shared a technique involving Excel's Goal Seek feature and operating it with a macro. This got my mind thinking of ideas, and I wanted to share this technique with you along with a few of my own developments, and it certainly seems to be a useful approach. While probably one of the best features in Excel, Goal Seek is quite clunky to use. It's hidden away in the data menu, so you need to know it's there to even find it. Wouldn't it be great if we could make it work with a single click? Or maybe automate it completely? Well, guess what? That's exactly what we're going to do in this video. If you want to work along with this video, you can download the example file, and you'll find links in the descriptions box below. Okay, if you're ready, let's get started. The scenario we're using is a simple business case based on sales units, sales price, cost price, and fixed costs. And from these, we can calculate a profit. The grey cells are the variables that are used to calculate the final profit. If one of those variable changes, so does our profit value. Let's look at using Goal Seek manually. Goal Seek is a feature that determines the input required to achieve a specific outcome. So in our example, let's assume we want to find out how many units we would need to sell to break even. From the ribbon, we'll click Data, What If Analysis, Goal Seek. And that will open up the Goal Seek dialog box. The parameters we want to apply are that our profit in cell E12 should be set to value 0 by changing cell C4. So that is, our profit should be set to 0 by changing the sales units. We'll then click OK. Excel will now try to find a possible solution so that cell E12 equals 0. And as you can see, the break-even position is if we sell 571 units. We're excluding any decimal places here. But if one of our other variables were to change, for example, if our sales price increased to 110, we'd need to run the same Goal Seek process again. And if something else changed, we'd have to run it again. It's quite a time-consuming process. Plus, if you're designing a spreadsheet for somebody else, then it's really not a great user experience. So let's move on to think about a more dynamic solution. How about a one-click Goal Seek? For this, we're going to use a macro attached to a button. Then anytime a variable changes, we just need to click one button to rerun the Goal Seek. In this scenario, the macro recorder will give us a solid starting point, so we're going to use that. Click on the developer menu. Now, if you've not got that visible, you can right click on any grey section of the ribbon, click customize ribbon, and then check the box down here that says developer. And that will make sure that the developer menu is visible. So from developer, we're going to click record macro. We're going to accept the default options, so we can click OK. And we're going to undertake the same steps we used a few moments ago. So we'll click data, what if analysis, goal seek again. We'll make the set cell E12, which is the profit, and we'll make that the value 0 by changing cell C4, which is the sales units. And then we can click OK. Then from the developer menu, we can click stop recording. Now let's go and have a look at our recorded code. So again, in the developer menu, we're going to click Visual Basic. This will open up the Visual Basic editor. And then we're going to look at our code in module 1. This is just a short few lines of code, which we can easily edit if needed. So first, let's take out the junk. And our code says that the range, being E12, will apply a goal seek where the goal equals 0 and by changing cell, which is the range of C4. We'll come back to the Visual Basic editor in a few moments, but for now it's okay to close this window. The final step in this section is to create a button to run the macro. From the menu, click Insert, Shapes, and I'm going to select the rectangle with rounded corners. But you can select any shape you like. The mouse will change to a cross, and then we can click on the worksheet and draw a shape to be the size that we want. If we hold the Alt key whilst doing this, it will also snap to the grid. I'll right click on the shape, click Assign Macro, and in the window that opens after that, I can set the macro that was recorded earlier, that was still called Macro 1. We can now format this shape however we like. Add a shadow. So I've called it Click Me and applied a few bits of formatting there. I'll just change our values back to how they were. And now anytime I click on the button, it will automatically run the goal seek. So if any of our variables change, we can simply click on that button and it will run the macro every time. Hopefully you agree with me that this is a much better user experience. So currently our macro uses hard-coded cell values because we use cell E12 and cell C4. Well, these can be dangerous in a macro, especially if a user inserts a row. If that were to happen, cell C4 and cell E12 are no longer the sales units or the profit number. So to make this more robust, we can use some named ranges. I'll press Ctrl Z to undo the inserting of the row. And now I'll start naming my variables. For cell C4, I'll call sales units. Remember, named ranges cannot have spaces in them. Cell D4 will become sales price. Cell D6 we'll call variable cost price. Cell E10 will be called fixed costs. And finally, cell E12 we will call profit. I just want to add something additional to this because currently we're assuming we always want a break-even value. So let's also add a target value onto this sheet. So I've written target value, and then I'll copy the formatting of that cell and put it onto I6. I'll enter a zero in there and call that named range of target value. Okay, let's head back into the Visual Basic Editor and make these changes into our macro. Cell E12 is now called profit. Cell C4 we named sales units, and then we will take out the zero from the goal and replace that with the range of target value. Okay, so close that to head back into Excel. And because we now have a target value, we can set that to any value that we like. So if our target value was 50,000, we'd enter that into cell I6. We could run the macro, and as you can see from that, we need to sell 2,000 units. Or if our target value were zero, we could enter that into cell I6 and run the macro, and again it would make our profit equal zero. When we use Goal Seek manually, if there isn't a solution that Excel can find, it will give us a message to let us know that it hasn't found a possible solution. Unfortunately, when running a macro, it doesn't give us this error message. So instead, we need to make sure that we create our own error check. Just move my macro down, then I'll select on cell F12, and I'll type equals if, open bracket, profit, which is our named range, does not equal target value, which is also a named range, comma. So our value, if that's true, and I'll say automated goal seek, no result found. Make sure that's in double quotes. Then a comma, and then the value if it's false is just two empty double quotes and close bracket. So if we had a scenario where our target value and our profit couldn't be made the same, what we would see is an error message coming up on the screen. Now, depending on the accuracy that you need, you might need to add in some rounding on these numbers to make sure that it's close enough for your requirements. Okay, now it's time for the next level stuff. We're going to make this goal seek completely automated. So I'm going to add two more variables onto this, one called set cell and one called change cell. I'll copy the formatting onto both of those and then make sure they've both got names. So the first one in I4 we'll call set cell, And then the second one in I8, we will call change cell. Then in cell I4, I'm going to put the word profit, because that is the named range that we use for cell E12. Then in cell I8, I'm going to enter the name sales units, because that's the name of cell C4. Okay, let's head back into the Visual Basic editor. So click Developer, then Visual Basic. So we'll hash out everything that we've got there in macro one, copy the code that we have there, because we'll use that in a few minutes. And then rather having the macro in a module, we're going to insert it into our worksheet module. So I'll double click on sheet one. Then from the drop downs at the top, I'm going to select worksheet and change, which means that this macro will run whenever cell values change. I'll create a variable called input cells, so dim input cells as range. I'll just add a comment in there to say I'm about to list all the input cells. Then I'll start to list all of my named ranges. So I'll go set input cells equals the range of open bracket, open double quote, sales units, comma, sales price, comma, variable cost price, comma, fixed cost, comma, and I'll just close that double quote and then ampersand space underscore to create a new row, and then I'll continue with that with target value, set cell, and change cell. And double quotes again with a closed bracket. Just add another comment in there to say this next section will run only if an input cell changes. Right, then I'll type if not application dot intersect open bracket range open bracket target dot address close bracket comma input cells close bracket is nothing then I'll close that if. So we've said there that we're only going to run the macro where the cell that is changed is one of those input cells. So if the cell changes and it's also the name of one of our named ranges, so sales units, sales price, variable cost price, etc., that is the only time that this macro will execute. I'll just add a comment here to say what the next line of code is that we're about to do. So we're going to run the goal seek using only the values in the set cell, target value, or change cell named ranges. Then I'll paste the section of code that we took from module one. And now we're about to edit that code so that only uses the set cell, target value, and change cell named ranges. So we're going to use the named range set cell. And in the worksheet at the moment, we have the value profit in there. So that second range that is wrapped around it, that's going to use the named range profit because that's what's in the set cell. Just click there, put an underscore, and then create a new line. And again, we're then going to change that section so it uses the name range called change cell. And that's currently pointing to sales units. So ultimately, that range will change to sales units. Okay, I'll just tidy that up there. Okay, there we have it. Right, back to Excel, and let's test this out. And we no longer need our button because we've now changed it for the worksheet change event. So I'll delete that. Now here we have it that the set cell and the change cell values in I4 and I8 must be the names of the named ranges. I can now change some of those values. And now we don't even need to click a button. It will goal seek every time. Well, that's all for me today. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment, and I'll catch you next time.